And if you heard it, maybe you ain't here for me. Unless you be on fucking Twitter, man. Let me tell y'all, 2 years ago, Carolina, 2 years ago when I got done with that tour, that same tour I told y'all about earlier, I finished the tour, I'm done with the tour, I take a second, I look around at my life, I look at my career, and I say, damn, you know what? I feel like I accomplished the shit that I set out to accomplish. You know what I mean? No, I'm not saying that for, I appreciate it, but I'm not saying that for fun. I'm just saying, I looked around and saw, oh shit, like, I feel good about where I'm at in life. I feel like this would be a good time for me to go back home. I was in New York for a long ass time, and I said, fuck it, I'm gonna go back to Carolina. Like, it's time. I did what I set out to do. If y'all know my story, you know, I went to New York to try to make this shit happen. And I'm looking around like, damn, it actually happened. Okay, let me take my ass back home. And plus, New York, expensive as fuck. Like, I ain't even fucking. Fuck, how much money I got, man? So I come back home, right? The first thing I do when I get back home, the first thing I do, I get me a house out in the suburbs. And I get this house for one reason. One reason only. It's always been one of my dreams to have a studio house. Just a house with a studio in it. You know what I mean? I'm a man nervous to have just a crib with a studio in it. And I ain't even talking about no high-tech shit. This ain't no Dr. Dre level shit. Nah. It's some home studio shit. You walk into the house, you go downstairs, it's some carpet, finished basement. I ain't gonna lie, we got some big ass speakers. That's about the most high tech shit we got. But right next to the speakers, we got old normal ass desks. Some of y'all probably got the same desk I got. Some shit from like IKEA or something, you know what I mean? I ain't gonna lie, that bitch is leaning though. It's leaning. You know what they can just put shit together without reconstruction. I got a comfortable ass couch. The most comfortable couch my ass has ever sat on. Right above this couch, I got posters and pictures on every inch of the wall. Every inch of the wall is covered with posters. And I'm talking about legendary people from our past, you know what I mean, from our culture, from our history, from our music. Legendary people. So when you walk into the room, you just see all these important people staring at you. So you feel the vibe right away. If you're a creative person, you walk in like, oh shit, it just gives you a vibe, right? Every day in this house, we doing some of the most positive shit that you can actually ever do. We making music, musical vibrations that hopefully one day will make their way from our house to where you are. You know what I mean? If you're having a shitty day, you just get in the car, put the shit on, maybe take your mind off some shit, or I might just turn you up. Who knows what it can do? But either way, it's gonna be positive. You can't really get more positive than the shit we doing in that house, right? Unless we turn it into a church or some shit. But we ain't evolved that far yet. So we do what we do. We make music. Some positive shit. So tell me why. Carolina, it's where we live now. Tell me why. One day, out the fucking blue, 15, 16, 17 SWAT police officers show up at my door wearing some ridiculous shit, by the way. Some shit from the future they had on. I don't even know what the fuck this was. I don't even think Donald Trump seen the shit they was wearing yet. I don't know if he's approved this. Clearly some shit they were saving for ISIS. And they just decided to use that shit on my fucking house for some reason. These niggas look like y'all ever play Call of Duty. These niggas look like some shit off Call of Duty. And you gotta pay extra to get the shit they was wearing. Big ass guns and shit. They show up to my house, they bust in the front door. Matter of fact, Carolina, I'm sitting here telling y'all about it. But I have the footage of these niggas. Can we please bring up fucking footage for Carolina so I can see these niggas in action? Look at this shit. Whose fucking gun is that? Watch this shit. He about to bust into the house right now. Count them up. Boom. 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 We're in. busted into a drug room right now. He knows it. He's so sure.
That's what I said. When I
got it. No, nigga, it's the fucking outside, you idiot. Oh, you look stupid right now. Now, this the slick shit. That's my pole stick, by the way. Watch what they do when they find out black people got cameras, too. Look at this shit. Dirty motherfucker. Now look, all of that. They went through all of that. They flew, by the way, I ain't got that many cameras, nigga. They flew helicopters over the house. They go through all of that. And what do you think they found inside the house? You fucking idiots. You could have just knocked on the front door, my nigga. Damn. I would have showed up extra humble. Probably in my drawers, like, hey, what the fuck? You got the wrong guy. So look, I don't know who they thought. Maybe they was coming to see with all that extra shit that they had on and the guns and shit. I don't know who the fuck they thought house it was. Maybe Pablo Escobar, I don't know. Maybe they thought I was one of the Migos, I don't fucking know. I know a nigga got dressed now, man. Damn. But look though, they didn't just randomly close their eyes and point at a house on a map and show up to my shit. Why do y'all think they showed up to my house of all houses? Fuck your neighbors. I wouldn't just make a song saying fuck your neighbors for no reason. Why would I do that? That's stupid. I got no problem with the neighbors. Except for these motherfuckers. And actually, I think it's one neighbor in particular. I don't want to shit on all my good white neighbors, you know what I mean? I think it was one motherfucker in particular. If I had to put money on it, I would say it's the motherfucker behind me. Why do I think that? I just got that feeling. You know, black people got a radar. You just tell. My motherfucking hair stands up. Why do I know that? Because when this nigga's outside mowing his lawn, his extra green for no reason lawn, he spent way too much time on grass. But he mowing his lawn. And while he's mowing his lawn, I can just feel the racist vibe exuding from this motherfucker. It's coming out his nose, out his eyes, his ears. I can feel that shit. Matter of fact, over the sound of the lawnmower, I can hear under his breath, he's saying some shit like, how the fuck did you nigga get over here in this neighborhood? It took me 27 long years to get here. So he did what he did. He called the police, and with no evidence, they did what they did. And I was mad as fuck. I promise y'all, I was hot. I wrote 19 rap verses against these niggas. I was about to drop an album and all that shit. On some NWA shit, my nigga. Y'all about to see a whole new Cole. Whole new J. Cole. Fuck all that college shit, nigga. Shit about to get physical. So I was hot, because what they did was fucked up. But then I started thinking about it, and I had to check myself too. And I'm gonna tell y'all why. I felt like I was guilty of something. In this country, as soon as a black man gets some money, what's the first place he wanna go move to? Exactly. 9 times out of 10, he gonna be right next door to somebody that don't want him there, intimidated by his presence, offended by his presence. But what we don't do is, we don't take that same money that house costs and go get some shit where we come from, invest in the community, you know what I mean, help build it back up. We don't do that. And we ain't gotta clap, because I'm guilty of the same shit. But think about it, it made me write this. Yeah. So much funk and separation, don't know what I was thinking. I'm moving back to Southside. Fuck these. So much funk and separation, don't jackets. Keep your frown on before they think you soft. Never smile on and take your defense off. Acting tough so much we start to feel hard. Live from the city where they pull cars. I got a Glock 40 and a Lil 9. Ready for the day they can pull mine. Niggas from the hood is the best actors. Gotta learn to speak in ways that's unnatural. Just to make it through the job interviews. If my niggas heard me, they say, hey, what's